This diagnostic test will help determine if you suffer from red-green color blindness. Can you identify the following numbers? If you had difficulties identifying the numbers, you may be suffering from red-green color blindness and should consult your local physician. Continue watching this video to learn more about this condition. How do we perceive color? Color vision works by using cells called cones that are located within the retina of the eye. Humans are trichromats, meaning they have three types of cones that are sensitive to different colors of light. The S cones are sensitive to blue light, the M cones are sensitive to green light, and the L cones are sensitive to red light. Color blindness occurs when the cone cells don't function properly. There are three overarching forms of color blindness. Monochromatism is the absence of all three cones, resulting in the inability to perceive color. Dichromatism is the presence of only two cones. Anomalous trichromatism is when all three cones are present, but color perception is atypical. Red-green color blindness falls into the categories of dichromatism and anomalous trichromatism, and is scientifically referred to as protanopia/protanomaly and deuteranopia/deuteranomaly. Protanopia is the loss of red L cones, resulting in only green-blue color perception, and deuteranopia is the loss of green M cones, resulting in red-blue color perception. According to Birch in 2012, the overall prevalence of red-green color blindness is approximately 8% in men and 0.4% in women that are European Caucasians, 5% in male Asians, and 4% in male Africans. These are chromosomes. Human beings have 23 pairs of chromosomes. The last pair are called sex chromosomes as they determine an individual's sex. XY represents males, whereas XX represents females. Chromosomes are structures that contain genes, and genes contain instructions that are responsible for the development of cells, tissues, and organs. Studies show that red-green color blindness is due to an atypical X chromosome. As a result, the prevalence for this condition is higher in males compared to females because it's X-linked recessive. Since males have one X chromosome and females have two, this means that males are more susceptible to the condition. For a female to express the red-green color blindness phenotype, both of their X chromosomes must be affected. If only one X chromosome is affected, then they are termed a carrier and don't display the phenotype, but are capable of passing down the condition to their children. Although people with red-green color blindness can live relatively normal lives, there are some limitations. Those that suffer from the condition are not able to choose certain career fields such as police enforcement, firefighting, and piloting. Here is some information from the perspective of someone with red-green color blindness. Meet Jordan. How did you know you had a visual color deficiency?
So I would say I was probably about 8 years old. The first time that I thought that I may have color blindness, I was coloring a map in school, and I colored the ocean purple, and the teacher made a comment about it and suggested that maybe I should be tested for color blindness. So I went to an optometrist, they gave me a test, and sure enough, yes, I do in fact have it.
How does this condition impact your daily life?
So in my daily life, it impacts me just looking at a computer system that I use in my workplace. There's a lot of different graphs that we use where all of the different information on it is color-coded, a lot of them being similar to one another. We've had to go in and make accommodations for myself, changing the colors of different lines so that I can differentiate them, as well as different types of equipment maybe running in a manual operation or an automatic operation, and it's a red versus a green color to identify which is which. So I often need help from coworkers in order to differentiate.
Jordan was asked to sort which colors he thought looked similar. noticed that Jordan was unable to distinguish between the light green, red, and orange. He also grouped the mint color with the pinks and the gray with the light purple. Did you know that there are aids available to help those that are colorblind? Although these products are not capable of enabling you to perceive color the same way as a person without this condition, they help differentiate shades. A lab at the University of Birmingham has developed dyed contact lenses that allow for better differentiation between red and green colors. Thank you for watching. We hope you are more informed about red-green colorblindness. If you think you may be suffering from this condition, we recommend you consult a doctor and refer to the following resources for more information.